If you don't want your street rod to become a very hot rod indeed, then the fan belt has to be working properly. What does the fan belt do? Well, first of all, it drives the water pump down there, which pushes the vital coolant through the cylinder block and keeps the engine at the correct working temperature. It also drives the alternator or the dynamo, which provides the charge for the battery. So it's a pretty important thing. In addition to all this, it may drive the fan. I say may because more and more cars, especially high-performance cars these days, are being fitted with electric fans, which have nothing to do with the fan belt at all. But even on those models, there will be some form of drive belt to drive that water pump and to drive the generator, whether it's the alternator or the dynamo. So the fan belt really is an important thing, and it's vital that it works properly. So what can go wrong with a fan belt? Two things. It either breaks and falls off, or it gets old and tired and stretches and begins to slip. If it breaks, well, yes, you've obviously got to replace it, but how will you know? Well, the engine will rapidly begin to overheat and the red charge warning light on the dashboard will come on telling you that the battery isn't being charged up. But perhaps slightly more devious is when it stretches and slips. It's true that the engine will be running just a little bit hot, but the first you'll probably know about it is one morning when you come down and try and start up and discover that the battery's gone flat. So if the fan belt has stretched and is beginning to slip, what you need to do is to retension it. Not a difficult job, but one that's fairly difficult sometimes to get at. And one tip, when doing this, remember you'll be working down in this area, which is near the exhaust manifold. That can be very, very hot. So the wisest tip of all, unless you're in a great hurry, is to allow the whole engine to cool down. And of course, the same applies if you're fitting a new fan belt, if the one that was on the car has broken. Let's start then here, at the top of the alternator, where we see this bolt, which, as you can see, passes through a piece of metal with a slot in it so that the alternator can slide up and down. What you do first of all is to slacken off the two bolts underneath the alternator, one on each side, under there. Tricky, because you frequently have to do it from underneath the car. When you've done that, you then slacken off this bolt at the top, which we will do, like so. When that's nice and slack, taking a long piece of metal, or a big screwdriver, and placing it at the side, like so, you push away, pushing the alternator out until the point when the fan belt here is at the correct tension. You will find the correct tension in your vehicle's handbook. It means the amount of free play on the longest run, and as a useful get-you-home emergency guide, about half an inch of free play is right. When you've got it to that situation, then you tighten up here again. And when you've done this, don't forget to tighten up the two vital pivoting bolts underneath. But a word of warning, do not try and play safe. Never over-tighten a fan belt. If that belt is too tight, if it's really tight, it will have a disastrous effect on the bearings here in the water pump, or here on the alternator pulley. And you'd be surprised, a very tight fan belt will work through those bearings almost in no time. So don't try and play safe. So, there we are. Final tip. Whatever you do and wherever you go, and especially if you're going abroad, always carry a spare fan belt of the right type to fit your car, and of course, the tools to do the job.